trying to play me out, baby. I feel so strange thinking about you after all the wrong you've done to me. I can't go on feeling like I do, 'cause my heart loves you. I'm so confused.
All the time I think of you. To play me out, baby.
Don't waste my time, 'cause someone like me you never find. I thought we had a good thing, but I was wrong, and now I must move on. Yeah. To another love, one that I can trust.
Thank you. treasure of his heart there upon his arm, eyes of midnight stars.
Babyface, you're playing Babyface.
That's Babyface.
It's okay.
So, do you want to hear Eric Benet?
Nah, I mean,
you did.
I want to hear some sweet Eric Benet vocals. Pause before anybody thinks anything. Not that it doesn't matter, but I mean,
nah, it's their business.
But I'm definitely a single male. I'm a single male. That's definitely a woman who loves women. not a woman.
It's a Trinidadian.
I'm a Trini. Anyway, how are you?
I'm good. How are you, babe?
It's been a while since I've been on the show.
Yeah, Skillit, Ryan.
Why you follow me?
Babe.
Why you follow me?
Come on. And you've got like salsa or something.
Come on, man.
Salsa on the people them. Yeah.
I feel like if I was Latino, I think my name would be Diaz.
I'll be a Diaz.
Yeah.
Is it? What would I be?
I'd be like Roberto Diaz. Haloto Andrade Haloto Diaz. I think that's what my name would be.
But that's same, like you now, but you're just Trinidadian. It's the same thing.
Why you follow me? Anyway, how's things?
It's good. And we'll catch up on where you've been gallivanting to. But this is Emma, Dominican Emz. This is a Dominican Emz show.
Ba 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 ba.
So yeah, this is Dominican Emz Show with me, your host. Dominican Emz with you between 2 and 4 each and every Saturday. In the background, you can hear Eric Benet while you follow me. We started off with the Sweet Boy tunes.
Was he with Halle Berry at this time?
Do you know what? I'd have to Google
it. He probably was.
But he fumbled the bag.
I don't know.
Why?
Halle Berry is...
She's still stunning.
Is she married?
She's in a relationship with some dude. Because I follow her on IG. She's with some man. He's not bad.
I don't know if Eric Benet fumbled the bag, to be honest.
He fumbled the bag.
I mean, she's a good looking girl, but we don't know what happened.
Yeah, I know. I'm being surface. So this is me, Dominican Emz. I am joined by my beautiful, glamorous co-host.
Hey, what up, everybody? My name is Ryan Skillit. You may have heard of me on the show before. As you can tell, I'm very tired.
No, but you're good. Even when you're tired, you're still high energy.
Thank you.
You are. How can they get in contact with us today, Rabbi?
I would say, you know, the best thing to do is call the studio number, which is 075-642-65257, and send your messages, you know, any questions you have that you want us to talk about, any topics you want us to talk about, you know, just, you know, WhatsApp us on the number, or you can just call in if you want, and we can put you on the speaker live on the show. We can have a chat with you.
Just don't say anything foul or weird or disgusting.
Yeah, just be a bit more, you know, yeah, be a bit PC with your language. Yeah. With your language.
Do you know what? This is like show 19.
Is it? It's 19.
Show 19.
Jesus! 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 Jesus!
And if you've been around me for 3 minutes, you know what a dirty mouth I've got.
And you've done really well. I mean, I've cursed more than you in this show.
Everybody has.
That's crazy. And I don't really even curse like that.
But it's like
life.
I've got Tourette's. As soon as I get outside the door, it's like...
Yeah, you can't help yourself. Yeah. Even like when children's around, you have to say something vile.
No, I do. It's really
vile
bad.
And vulgar.
It's very bad. So yeah, this is Dominican Emz. I'm joined by Skillit, my co-host. We are sponsored by Customers On Demand.
Jesus!
And Customers On Demand help service-based businesses build their brand online, find their ideal target audience and convert them into what? Customers. Mm. And over the past 4 years, Customers On Demand have helped over 200 companies double their turnover in 30 to 60 days.
Come on.
You know? Like, I love what they're doing, and thank you always to them for supporting this and what we're doing. And like, I've just loved seeing them grow and just smashing it in the marketing field. Mm. In terms of housekeeping, I'm part of Notting Hill Carnival. We're going to be joined by 2 guests today as well. Funny enough, speaking of that, we have Coldchizzle, who's not here right now, but we'll be joining us. I don't know what I'm putting into an empty chair.
Yeah, I think I've seen empty chairs right now.
He's
darling.
An invisible man,
right,
from St. Lucia.
Cool, man. I am invisible man.
He's an invisible man. And we are also going to be joined by the legend Djmartinjay. And what's going to be banned is when Martin comes, he doesn't like people doing that icon legend stuff. He doesn't
like to call himself an icon or legend.
He doesn't, but
he's been around the game for ages.
He's been around, but also he's so instrumental behind the scenes in people's careers, so we'll touch on that.
I mean, it's so strange that icons and legends don't like to be called icons and legends.
Isn't it?
But then we'll give him his flowers when he gets here.
We're gonna give him his flowers. But the real boasty ones ain't done nothing. Well, the real boasty ones.
Yeah, the ones that talk don't, they ain't really bad, innit?
Parley, parley.
Do more, speak less.
You know? And then also, so Djmartinjay runs Funatik Mas. They've been on the road for like, I think, over 10 years.
Jesus!
I know. I missed you, Ryan. And I'm with Funatik Mas on the road for Notting Hill Carnival.
Oh, wicked. I can't wait for that. Carnival's going to be amazing this
year.
Yeah,
you know, man. You're on the road with me, no question.
I have to be, yeah. I might have to hit the gym weights, though. I mean, I've been going to gym, but I don't do a lot of cardio. I need to stop doing that. I need to start working
on... What kind of cardio are you doing?
I love running, innit? That's my favourite type of workout. Yeah, that's another type of cardio as well. Yeah, marathon man.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's good, thank you.
Cool.
We're going through a tea later, hopefully. Oh. I don't know.
Is that actual right or euphemism?
Euphemism.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice. So we're on the show. I'm on the road of Notting Hill Carnival. That's my train of thought. Talking about like back
you're
and
so
out.
Funny.
I can't even keep it up. So we're going to be talking.
That's what she said. Okay, stop it. I mean, that's quite. Yeah. Anyway.
No, it is what it is. So we're going to be on the road.
Yeah.
They're going to be launching. We're going to be talking to mine all about that. Mm. I have launched. My costumes are on sale now.
Jesus!
thank you to everybody that's purchased so far.
Come on.
If you've got any questions, and if there's like a style of question that you want as well, just ask me. Like, it's part of the process. Like, if you want something a bit more skimpier, like what Ryan would have, or something a bit more covered, then you just let us know. Just let us know, and then we'll cater to you, and we'll make sure that you're looked after. And the earlier that you come to us, the better as well.
For any football fans that are listening to the Dominican Emz Show right now, Arsenal is winning. They are beating Man United 3-1.
Jesus!
So, just in case any football fans were interested.
Niceness. And you know I'm a gooner, so thank you for mashing up Man United. And also, in terms of last bit of housekeeping, we have the costumes, because I launched online, we'll be actually at the Just Vibes boat party on Saturday the 30th. If you want tickets, you can get them via Eventbrite. If you want to see me there, come down. Just don't touch me or talk to me too much. But yeah, I don't know, it'd be nice.
Yeah. Sanitize them hands.
Yeah, sanitize your hands.
Hey, shout out to Davinia. Davinia and Karen. You know Davinia and Karen?
Yeah.
Apparently she's on what reality show is it? Like The Voice
no
or something?
Way.
She's on something today.
No way.
Do a public vote for her. Hopefully she does well. I think it's 8 p.m. Whatever them shows is.
Really?
I was really bad that I don't know when it's, maybe it's Britain's Got Talent. I think she's on that.
No way.
Yeah, I think she's on there tonight.
I missed that.
So good luck to her.
We love
her. And hopefully she'll get voted in. I won't be watching, but I will lie to her and text her and tell her that I've watched and voted for her.
Yeah, so it goes.
I'm joking. Well, no, truth and jest.
So, guys, as we just wait for... Oh, the guys are coming. They're on their way. So as we just wait for them to just get themselves in. So like we said, who have we got on the show today? We've got Romell. Romell Marquis, also known as the St. Lucian Don, the producer.
The St. Lucian Don. Don Carleon. Yeah.
I kind of made that up on the spot.
Though. Oh, did you? Mm. Oh, maybe we should call him that.
I'm going to. I'm going to act natural, just like I said it for the first time too.
Man's the man.
Such a Ryan, where have you been and what have you been doing?
I just came back from good old Texas from the USA, the good old US of A. I was there to document and report on WrestleMania, the granddaddy of all the wrestling pay-per-views for the WWE. I have a working relationship with them, myself and DJ Ace. We have a podcast called The Kick Out Podcast. Mm-hmm. And also have another podcast called The Gorilla Position, who also is, we were working down in Texas to do take care of work for
so
them as
cool.
well. So yeah, it was good fun. I got to see my hero, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
You did it.
And I saw him live. I saw him wrestling. Came out of retirement for one match.
How old is he now?
He's probably in his like mid-50s, 55.
He looks amazing.
He still looks great. He's great shape.
But he's like Stone Cold still Steve Austin.
Yeah. Still cutting them promos, still drinking them beers. He drinks worse than you, which is, I think, it's unbelievable. I just think you're the worst drinker I've ever seen in my life. She gave me a little swig of a drink earlier and I was like, I thought I was going to die.
That is, what I told you about that. That's actually water.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, since I've been back, I've just been working and doing a lot of charity events for the Black Cultural Archives.
And that's who you work for during
that's
the week?
That's what I work for. I do a lot of work for them. There's a big plan coming up with them soon, so.
Have you got a video coming up as well?
I got music. I got some new music dropping soon, which I'm just, you know, I'm just putting on pause for a little bit because I just want to get other things done, other projects done. But yeah, music will be coming soon. Hopefully by the summer,
so
I'll get some
excited.
New songs coming. Yeah, yeah, me too. I'm excited for it, so. Yeah, man.
Okay, so can we touch on some news this week?
Yes, please.
All right, so. Where do I put it? Sorry, people.
ASAP Rocky. Let's talk about him first.
Yeah, go on then.
Apparently he got arrested.
Yeah.
He got detained in an
You have to wheel and come again. One second. You have to wheel and come again. Because didn't they have the whole alleged allegations?
That wasn't true though.
No, it wasn't. The guy came out, but that was horrible. She's in the final stages of her pregnancy. I thought that was so bad.
I feel like people want her to lose his baby the way people are going on, man. It's crazy.
It's wicked, isn't it?
It's horrible, man. She doesn't need the stress. But first there was that stupid rumors that he cheated on Rihanna, which wasn't true. But apparently, what might be true is he shot at one of his ASAP, former ASAP members back.
Allegedly
shot at them, and that might be true.
I heard allegedly that it was actually because we were all wondering where did this random story come from. Apparently, another ASAP person
said it.
Yeah, did you hear about that as well? Sometimes it be your own people.
100%. So mental. I mean, the ASAP thing is all falling apart anyway. Like, ever since ASAP Yams died, it's just been one issue after another with that crew.
Who's the one that did Shabba Ranks?
Right, is ASAP Ferg?
Is There's so many of them. I can't keep up.
ASAP Ferg.
I can't even keep up. So in other news this week as well, we had the anniversary of Stephen Lawrence's passing. Well, he's not even passing, his brutal murder. Let's just be frank. We speak how we speak outside, we'll speak how we speak here. So Stephen Lawrence, as we all know, is somebody that's quite pivotal in not just Black British history and society, but UK history, UK society, in terms of what we all witnessed growing up. I don't even know how old I was when that happened. I must have been really, really young.
Was it 1993?
Yeah, so I would have been about 11, 12. You would have been really little, right?
I would have been like eight. I think I would have been 7 to 8.
Yeah, because there's 5 years between us. It was just, even then, you kind of knew it was something.
Yeah, sad.
So, yeah, up to this day, his family is still to receive like justice for what has happened. Mm. It's really, really bad. I really feel for them. But I like that they've marked the day with an annual commemoration of him, and that he was about, you know, what he was trying to achieve and what he was trying to do. And also that we're not going to give up again and still fight racism and still fight like anti-blackness. Oh, in this
100%. 100%.
Did you see our school was in the newspaper? Was in the
for
newspaper?
The racism thing with the.
I got it from your brother actually. That's why I saw it posted.
Apparently, a teacher said the N-word or something like that.
No.
What was the situation? I can't remember now.
So essentially, there was. I think the movie is called The Trap.
Okay.
It's got a comedian called Mike Epps.
Mike Epps.
So
they're showing a Mike Epps movie in school.
Yeah.
College.
And the students allegedly in question were about 14 years old. And so you've gone to class, you're a 14-year-old Black child, and then you've questioned to your teacher, who is non-Black, allegedly, why is it okay in this situation for you to put on this movie in this class? And it's featuring the N-word, because I don't know about you, as many people use it, it is in songs that I listen to. I probably hear the word every day, but I personally never use that vocabulary.
Yeah.
It's just not in me. So the 14-year-old has gone and questioned their teacher, who's non-Black, why is that okay? And then they said something along the lines of Black people kind of use that stereotype, so what do you expect kind of thing.
Yeah, like kind of justifying it or something.
Yeah,
like that.
They literally justified it. That is, you've hit the nail on the head.
Why would you say that though? It's ridiculous. I just hope it's no one that I went to school with, because I know a lot of people in my year are now teachers in Holy Family now. I just hope it's none of them.
Headbutton, I hope it's allegedly.
Not. I really hope it's not anyone that I was in my class or in my year.
And it's gone to the Board of Governors, but I don't think anything happened. I think until it went
to because it's gone to press, there might be something that's happening now. I think they were going to probably bury it under the carpet before the back their teacher. But now that it's kind of gone a bit to press a bit, they might. I mean, it hasn't blown up to the magnitude of, like, you know what I mean? But
what, Child Q the other week? No.
Yeah, it hasn't blown up to that, because it wouldn't, but who knows?
It's might be bad.
Like, yeah, that's terrible. Like, I don't know why the teacher would think.
Our school has always been
multicultural. If someone's a bit upset about hearing the N-word in this field, I think that's their right to be upset about it. All you have to say is, like, really sorry. Maybe that was probably poor judgment of me to play that film.
Yeah.
And that's it. Keep it moving. Don't go on like, hey, it's okay. I mean, I'm playing it because Black people are justified using it. Black people are stereotypes. And Black people are this and that.
And that's exactly, you're like, that's like a Black Charlie Brown noise that you just made.
Yeah.
Because that's what they sound like. It's the impact and what's the word? Intent versus impact.
I have to admit, I'm loving this Eric Benet song that you're playing.
It's banging, isn't it?
I've never heard this before.
Really?
This is banging. I never really got into Eric Benet. I did like the song she did with Faith Evans, but it's not. But that was a cover. That wasn't an original song. The Georgie Porgie put
in. Oh,
the original was from Toto.
Yeah,
you know me. You know me and my nerdy stuff. But
we're both nerds, actually.
But I never really got into Eric Benet as a musician. I always felt he was a bit of a bootleg Maxwell. But this is a tune, though.
Yeah, it's banging.
Why are you so lonely?
We'll come back to some news later, but I think we're going to go and play some more music.
Okay.
But what else have you seen in the news, though, right, this week?
I feel like my brain is scrambled at this moment. There's definitely something topical. I saw did you see the thing with Mike Tyson?
Yeah, but what are you troubling Mike Tyson?
Yeah, so but people don't understand that. See, that guy, he's an influencer, so that's what he does.
Oh,
he does that to piss people off.
Is that why he was making that moo moo face?
Yeah, he
is
does.
That why he was doing
he
do, that?
He does these things to piss celebrities off to get, so he can get punched up and stuff. It's like,
well, you deserve it.
That's
then.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Because that's what he was looking for. He was looking for that reaction.
Because tell me if I'm wrong. So Mike Tyson, obviously we know, like, if you followed any of his stories, you watch any of the movies, you watch any of the whatever, you've seen what he's been doing, and he kind of went from having like a really troubled upbringing to having people that mentored and guided him to like growing up, and then obviously we know of all this stuff that happened allegedly in the press, to this person that we see now. Like, he's gone on like a kind of personal or spiritual journey. I'm not
well,
really
sure. He has. Why would you disturb that peace?
And I'm gonna kind of repeat something I heard Charlemagne the God say, so I can't even say it and take credit for this, but it was like, the man probably deserved it, because like, you're kind of, you're, if you keep coming at somebody, you're gonna,
what do you
get
mean,
a
probably
reaction.
He definitely deserved it. It's poking a bear.
Yeah.
You don't go and poke a bear.
And it's Mike Tyson.
Exactly. Of course, no, but I don't think the guy's gonna press charges. I think he knew what he was doing, and he
He's
was
a movie.
and he wanted that reaction, and he wanted to get punched up because it'll help him and his viewers, and look, it'll get people talking about it. I didn't know about this guy before now.
I didn't.
So that's what I'm trying to say. So,
this,
so
a,
it was a plot
bear.
For him to get punched up and for him to get viewers, and that's what he knew what he was doing. He's not gonna press charges or anything like that. If he does, that'd be disgraceful. So, another thing we need to talk about, Amber Heard and Johnny Depp. Have you been following this thing?
That was horrendous.
She's a whole mess.
Can we talk about gender stereotypes and the perception? And I'm gonna sound like a pick me, that it's always guys that are the ones who gaslight, it's always guys that are the ones who are narcissists. No, they're not.
Yeah.
I even have people that are like meant to be friends that I've seen some of their behaviours, and I'm just like, whoa.
Right.
Because you know how people are in relationships versus how they are as friends can be completely entirely different.
Absolutely.
What I heard was insane, but she's kind of ruined his career.
She has, but she's now, with this everything that's going on in court, she's ruined her own career. She's gonna be done.
I can't.
She's gonna be done.
I've got to 18 weeks without using any bad words, but she cackled on the bed.
Yeah, she did.
she was laughing
as they were playing the tape of her admitting that she threw something at him and punched him in the jaw afterwards. She slammed a car door in his head. There was a situation where she slammed the car door there, and she goes, oh, and it's on tape, yeah? She slams the car door in his head, and she goes, oh, sorry, I didn't mean to do that. And he goes, and Johnny goes, so you didn't mean to slam the car door in my head, but then you punched me in the face straight afterwards. She goes, yeah, I meant to do that. So you're telling me you didn't mean to slam the car door on my head, but your reaction after you slammed the car on your head, not to check if I'm okay, but your reaction was to check, was to punch me in the face. You're telling me
it's
that both
nonsensical.
You did the same thing. You did both actions on purpose, basically.
So repeat to me, what did she do?
She slammed the car door on his head and then punched him in the face afterwards. And then she had to apologize, saying that she didn't mean to slam the car door on the head. But then he goes, but why didn't you punch me in the face afterwards? Exactly. And then she starts saying, oh, are you gonna say that you're being abused now? Like, she tell you, like, women, like, men can't get abused by women. That's what
she's
saying.
Which they can.
She's like, you're like twice my size.
That means
that's
nothing.
That's ridiculous. Ridiculous.
That's actually evil. Right, you know, I'm going to... We never play that much R&B. I'm going to play a little bit more. This
play a
next
bit
one
R&B.
Is from Omar Kader, and it's called Catch Up.
Let's go.
Girl, let me show you what you need right now. How many shots did you take? I can feel your knees getting weak, slow down. Why you trying to catch up? You catch up too fast. Why you trying to catch up, girl? Oh, oh. Pulled up, full cup. You got a gas, I could pull up in a tow truck. I'm a California boy in a gold rush. Pay respect to the game, cause it spoiled us. And now that we on, I can't recall her name. And if I saw her face, I got too many thoughts on my ooh, brain. I try to leave her, but she tell me with a good time. Ooh, but I call the client line, but it's also on my timeline. Need a girl on a long shot, but we made it cloudy. The next I made her rain. She got more curves than that new Bentley Moose. And she ain't fell love all week. Girl, let me show you what you need right now. How many shots did you take? I can feel your knees getting weak, slow down. Why you trying to catch up? You catch up too fast. Trying to catch up, girl. Help me.
focus. Hands in the soap. How the faucet's running and I keep looking at you. Stuck on your phone, now you're stuck in your zone. You don't ever cook, but I don't wanna give up. Baby, I just want you to get up. Lately, I've been a little fed up. Wish you would just focus on me. Can you focus on me? Baby, can you focus on me? Me, can you focus on me? Baby, can you focus on me?
iLife Radio. Changing the way you listen to radio.
This is Ada Divine, and you're listening.
This money, so I guess I can't complain. But I feel alone even when we're alone. Te amo, she says to me. I hear the pain in her voice. Then we danced underneath the candelabra. She takes the lead. That's when I saw it in her eyes. It's over. And she said, "Te amo, the ship put her in her army waves." I told her no, she cried, "Te amo." I told her I'd never run away. Let me go. I sold it to cry. Without asking why, I said, "Te amo." Somebody tell me what she said. Don't it mean I love you? Think it means I love you. Don't it mean I love Te amo, Te amo. She's scared to breathe. I hold her hand, I got no choice. Son, put me out on the beach, dance in the water. I start to leave.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Especially when you
So guys, you may have noticed we've been joined by a Rastaman who drinks water when we're about to say his name. Mr. Rastaman, how are you?
I'm Gucci, man. I'm Gucci, man.
Nice to see you. I'm good.
Mwela.
Yeah. So we have my co-host, Ryan Skillit.
Yes, brother.
And we have Coldchizzle.
Bad boy.
AKA Romell. Marquis or Marquis?
Marquis.
Yeah. So when I was looking into you, I just assumed you're Lucian.
I'm Lucian.
You are Lucian, but you were born here like me, and I'm Dominica,
exactly,
right?
Exactly that. We related. Creole island. Sistrin island, we there.
I love St. Lucia, you know.
But I love Dominica, seems.
Yeah, nice, isn't it? But it has got that brother sister thing going on, yeah, proper. Did you feel it when you went there?
Always, from before we went there.
Yeah.
I go there all the time.
Yeah, so. But there's a lot of people who have like both the heritages as well. Yeah. And I've got Martin.
Yeah, there's a lot of Dominican and St. Lucian mixed people that I've met.
Lady Razor is Dominican. She's
One girl I dated was half Dominican, half St. Lucian. She was lovely as well. She was sweet. It just didn't work.
I think the guys are just saying, if you can lift your mic up.
I also speak like hella low. I don't know why. In my mind, I'm speaking really loud.
Is it like a Lucian Barry White? Is that what you're doing?
I think so, you know. I'm not even trying, I swear to you.
Just a Gallus.
Plus, I had a difficult night as well.
Is it? What was her name?
Oh, I might remember in like an hour or something.
Oh, wow. This is hilarious. Coldchizzle. You got to put the horns for that one. You got to put the horns for that one.
Jesus! It's the life we live, man. It's the life.
Yeah. But you're always working. You're always busy.
That's exactly it.
You're my second guest today. You're somebody that's like really instrumental in the scene. I'm going to give you your flowers.
So done. All right.
No, you are. And you've been working here and abroad for years.
Yeah, just doing his thing. Just doing his thing.
Doing your thing, but you're not one of those ones who's like looking for the accolades, but you are getting the accolades and you're getting like the hits, the numbers.
The work is speaking for itself.
Literally. So my guest today is Romell Marquis. He is a singer, songwriter, video vixen, after what I've just seen in
number one bread burner.
Bossy.
Like me, Leo.
Talented. You have written and produced songs for different genres. Mm-hmm. But so in terms of like what most people would know you for, in terms of like our interactions on the soca scene, will be like Hyper Sounds, Trini Boy Juicy. Who are some of the other names that you've got as well?
Motto.
Yes.
Mackie Levin.
And Black Boy with
Black Boy.
Chicken and Rice and his version on the rhythm. What was it called again?
Faye. Yeah.
What does that mean in Creole? Do it.
Do it.
I'm learning.
It will come fluent to you. Trust me. It's
one day. I'm 40. Maybe when I'm 8, I'll speak.
No, man. It will come to you easily. Trust me.
It's in me.
It's there.
But yeah, so you're our guest today and we want to learn a bit more about you and what you've been doing. Yeah. And I think one thing that's been interesting to get to know about you as well is that we might know you for soca, we might know you for bouyon and like all the other bits that you've done, but you actually do so many different genres.
Yeah, literally. It's actually wild.
Wild. That's great though. That's like, what made you, like, is there a fact that you growing up, you were so enthralled in music that you felt you had the confidence to make all kinds of genres of music?
Yeah, well, my brother was a sound engineer and producer for Jive Records.
Okay.
So growing up, I saw a lot.
Right.
So, like a lot, the Aaliyahs, the Kellys, the Brandys.
My God.
I've seen all of that. So I kind of peeped low key, not what to do, but the air.
You are studying as well. When you're looking, you observe, you're studying.
Literally,
as well.
That's what it is.
What's your brother's name?
Levi Marquis. Yeah, so boom. Another Lucian.
Big up to Levi Marquis, man.
Yeah.
How so, tall is he?
6'1".
Okay, cool.
Yeah, 6'1", 6'2".
Every week I do.
It's calm, man. That's what we're here for, questions. But yeah, that's how I ended up getting through the other genres,
isn't
it? It's
for investigative purposes.
That's fine. Google me.
That's it, you can get my number and everything.
Right. You know? But yeah, that's how I kind of got through to other genres. A few of my friends, affiliates that I grew up with, but being St. Lucian, you end up being exposed to like I grew up on country and western.
Yeah,
yeah,
literally country and western and zouk, maybe a bit of reggae like Lucky Dube and so for Bunny Wailer, but
Amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Kadance. You guys had Kadance.
Yeah,
like
we have Kadance. Yeah, we follow, like, it's everything with the same culture.
Same. So Ryan, here, question for you. As our token Trinidadian, mm-hmm. would you have listened to country music as much as our family?
Yeah, 100%. My mom's a massive country fan.
Yeah. Massive. I love it, you know.
Yeah, so, yeah, I get all of that influence.
I can't even laugh at the Yardies, you know, when they have this to the
Dion.
Yeah,
they know it as well. They know it for, like, they yard. They're proper yard, but they know the songs. They know all the singing it as well. Word for it's word, wild. You know them where they.
But it's mad because even the kids, like in Lucia, even the kids, it's like they know all the songs word for words. Even the songs that's not big,
yeah,
but they're big in Lucia.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So like
yeah, yeah.
John Hogan, for instance, he's an Irish country and Western singer.
Right.
Not big in many places in this planet.
I've never even heard.
I'm gonna be honest. Now Ryan said that I haven't heard of him.
So, but when he went to St. Lucia. Like, he was surprised he got a booking for Jazz Festival, and my man literally cried his eyes out when everyone's singing word for word.
That's beautiful. I love that, man.
And St. Lucia Jazz Festival is like one of the most prestigious music festivals in the whole entire world. For anybody that's not aware, it's like one of the places to be, right?
That is it.
Do you know what it is as well? It just shows, like, you need to try and find your audience, man. Because you could be grinding for years making music in this country.
See,
yeah,
I love Ryan, you know?
You could be making pure music in this country. No one knows who you are, but you don't even realize people just in the Caribbean or in Africa or whatever are listening to you.
The best ticket that I learned for that is like, don't follow what's out there.
Don't.
You can't look for a market when you're peeping what other people's market is.
Exactly.
It don't make no sense. Exactly. Like, what are you bringing to the table 100%. If you're not being you? Do you know what I mean?
So, question. So, you were with your, like, around your brother, and you were listening. How did that kind of transpire into, like, how you got into things?
Well, I started DJing. So, it just got to a point where I got bored of DJing, playing the same songs over and over again. People.
And what was your genre and speciality?
I'll say soca. Early days of dennerysegment before it had a name.
Because you were a soca frenzy, I'm sure. I'm older.
Yeah, I was one of the. Yeah, I was one of the main DJs out there for soca frenzy as well. Big up the whole soca frenzy, Master Same Speed. But yeah, and I just got a bit bored of playing the same stuff, hearing the same things, and I just from hearing that the same ear thing from my brother, and I was like, I can do better than this. Do you get me? Literally. So I just started exploring into making beats and whatnot, and then literally first things that we started working on was with Motto. Like, this is before.
And what kind of year are we talking?
Ooh, probably 2012.
Okay.
Wow, maybe. Literally 10 years ago.
Yeah, maybe 2012.
Yeah.
With Motto. So before I was already doing stuff like Soca Bandit and every other people, just from Lucia mainly.
Yeah.
A couple people from here might know them now. KZ, Mr. Zine is a producer.
Yeah.
He's actually from around here. But he's doing really well mainstream here in the UK and across the US. And
what was their name?
Kwame Kweama, the son of Kwame Kweama.
No
so he's Kwame Kweama Jr. Yeah.
And what genre is that?
He does soulful trap. It can be anything really to do. So most of like you might hear he's worked for like Western and Estelle, mate. Just Google him, you'll get a whole long list. Yeah, that's my guy.
People need to Google you, mate, because it's like, who haven't you worked with? Literally.
It's through him I met my guy, Bobby Lewis. He's the one who's got me into all the other things that we spoke about.
So. I've got two tracks of Bobby's, actually.
Yeah, he is so cold. He's probably the planet's greatest.
Is he?
Trust me.
And his genres. Tell us about the songs that you made for him. And I'll cue them up. We can listen to them now.
What we basically do mainly is we co-write a lot together because he's an artist, but he's a songwriter. He's probably the biggest songwriter that is in K-pop.
Right.
Right. So the whole sound of K-pop, even though it's R&B and mixed.
So he's one of the most influential in that genre.
In that genre.
Crazy.
He's pretty much doing the same thing here in the UK with the scene how it is in the UK. So
mine.
I've got one here called Friends and Lovers.
That's with Steph London, yeah.
Yeah, and this is one that you produced by yourself?
No, this is produced by KZ, I believe. Kwame, yeah. So it's work that we've co-written on and just...
So you've co-written on this?
With Bobby Lewis, yeah, man. And then
so why are you saying it like that, like you didn't do nothing?
Everyone says that to me, you know. It's like it's my persona. It's like I like giving people flowers. I don't big myself up enough.
Yeah,
like,
right,
you know, everyone says that. That's just me, man.
Like, you're going to stop that today. Not. So here is Friends and Lovers by Bobby Lewis.
You call me when you're lonely. said we're homies. Yeah, we don't need to force it. It's awkward falling. Baby, take time, you're not running a race. You wanna be happy, but feelings get in the way. Hope you never imagine you'd be spending your day looking at all of the comments on my page. And I probably shouldn't do this now, cause I can see you're about to lose your mind. And that's not the best way to remember each other. Cause we had the thing right, friends and lovers. And that's not the best way to remember each other.
That is so nice.
Yeah, Bobby's crazy. We crazy.
I think the writing's nice in that as well.
Like I said, man.
Who did that?
Co-written, Bobby Lewis and myself.
Jesus!
Why are you so humble? I like it, but at the same time, I'm like claiming the flowers.
I don't know. I feel like, I'll give you my honest opinion.
Say it. I like honest around here.
If I wasn't humble, I don't think I would have got a lot of the opportunities I did get.
Honestly.
Right. I'm being very honest.
I think he's right though, because
I agree.
You know why I say that? Obviously when I was doing my music thing full time, and I just remember, like, I'm not gonna mention who it is, but a big
say
time.
It.
No, I'm not gonna say. But a big
it'd be like that game where you have to guess.
They're not black. He's a big time DJ. Big time DJ.
Does it rhyme with Charlie Puff?
Yes. Big up Gary the Roach.
Order the Peaky Blinders.
Order the Peaky Blinders.
Come on.
Him and Gary, I'm not going to say that guy's real name, but Gara the Roach, it rhymes with the person's whose real name is.
Yeah.
You can figure it out if you decipher it.
Yeah.
Came up to him and they were like, oh, Skillit, man, we love your new music video. It's really banging, man. You know what? We think like you can do like great things. Like we honestly believe in you. Think you can do something in this industry. And I was like, yeah, I think so too. But I didn't say it like, yeah, I think so too. I just said it like, I think so too. And they were like, all right.
Really?
Like, humble yourself. And I was a bit like,
that's not rude.
I was a bit like, huh?
Okay.
That's not bad what you said.
No, I know. But
do you know what it is?
I must have come across arrogant. I don't know.
But there's confidence and there's arrogance. Why can't a black man be confident and not seen as that aggressive?
I've seen that in certain situations before.
Why do you have
to
be so passive and like thankful?
I feel some people just live too much according to the same thing we're talking about, the accolades.
Mm.
See, if you had accolades already, they would have never been like, all right, calm down.
Yeah, it's true.
You get what I'm saying? But they don't know what your journey is.
Yeah, exactly. They don't. I know.
But if you feel that way, and you're like, yeah, I know that can be my journey. Like, who's I can name him Charlie Sloth. Like, who is he to
tell you that you can't feel that way? But it wasn't. You know what? Bro, to pick up to, you know what? I don't want to say that it was. I don't want to throw Charlie Sloth on the bus like that because it wasn't really him. It was
allegedly
the other guy.
It was
more the other guy.
To be honest, it could have been Jazzy Jeff, bro. It don't matter who. It don't matter who it is, and it's not even a shot. It's not even a shot at Charlie Sloth.
Yeah, it's not at all. No. I got love for them, man. Anyway, I got love for them, man.
I respect him a lot. I watch his shows all the time, bro. Fire in the Booth is wild. Even the one he did in Jamaica recently is wild.
Yeah.
So yeah, I big him up.
He had me in one of his first ever Fire and Abuse. Charlie Sloth had me on there. So big up Charlie Sloth though. Big himself. 100%.
That's my thing. Every time I mention in gang, I'm like, by order the Peaky Blinders. Yeah.
But you're just like we were saying, there's so many genres that you've touched, and like even this week, I've seen this song by a black boy who we've actually had on the show.
There you go.
And it's a chicken and rice for dinner. Controversial this week, you see.
I've seen the controversy.
But why do people just like Roro? They're like, Roro is like Bacchanal.
Right.
Well, it's good. Right. It's good. It's good.
Is it good for the numbers?
We'll have a great conversation.
Let me play 1 second of it and then we'll come back
there
to
we
it.
Go.
Jeune femme couchée au bassin soleil. Pas juste vivant, vous t'aimez pour mes oreilles. Vous t'aimez habiter ma sens à tout ça ouvert. Fermé, clap, cordé les mains. Open, close, make it round of applause. Make the blé, make it jiggle. You a special type of beat. Y'all sing this in the world. Just fade, fade, fade. It's not just fade, fade, fade. Met a mellow, fade, fade, fade. It's not just fade, just fade. Pass me a mellow, fade, fade, fade. It's not just fade, fade, fade. Mess up, it's not just fade, fade, fade. Shoulder, two safe, just fade. Two safe, just fatsa, usa batsa. Ta, in like a helicopter. Ta, don't upa bise dencha. We struck cha, cha, drop cha.
We just been joined by someone, and when I text him, he cringes. When I message him, he cringes. But I'm just gonna say he's a legend.
Jesus. Jesus.
So you've just witnessed a cringing person. I love Martin. I'm gonna say I love Martin.
Original.
Martin, can you come this way a little bit? Actually, so that's my bad. Yeah, a bit more. Come on, you guys get cozy, get sexual.
Sorry, but that was your foot, my bad. Yeah. All right.
That's actually all right. Could you do a little bit more comfortable? You'll find there, Marto.
I'm
all right. Yeah? Okay, nice, nice. So, guys, it is just approaching the hour. It is 2:57. This is me, Dominican Emz. In the back, you can hear Face Star by Hypersound. We have been joined by Martin J, who we will catch up with after the break. But, yeah, we have Hypersound. We have Martin J. I'm confused. We have Coldchizzle, aka Romell, the Lucian Gallius, and then we have Skillit.
Thank you. Lucian Gallius. Have you said the Lucian Dunn? Yeah, you're not called the Lucian Dunn.
Okay.
I changed it up. You can't keep saying the same
Lucian
thing.
Lucian Gallius now, yeah.
Martin actually teaches me. Martin told me that you've got to like keep it up.
Okay.
Like,
keep it I need a name anyway.
Lucian Gallus works.
Yeah, I was thinking of Jack Sparrow or something crazy like that. I don't know why, but yeah, Lucian.
Amber Heard.
Have you heard that story, Marto? Have you heard the story this week? Because we were talking about the news earlier. Will you be quiet, man? I'm actually joking. I want you to talk. I'm talking. Because we were talking about the news earlier, and one of the things that we were talking about was Johnny Depp and Amber Heard. Did you hear anything of that story?
No, I just saw a picture in the newspaper.
Is it? Rai, can you elaborate for us?
No, it's just about the domestic abuse claims between both of them, actually. They've both been claiming that one's been abusing the other. So they're both in court right now, and they're talking about it. And it seems that Amber Heard is very toxic. That's what it seems like. But, you know, That's pretty much it in a nutshell, really.
So the conversation we were having is in terms of like gender stereotypes, and guys, I'm just going to say we've got 2 minutes up to the hour. In terms of gender stereotypes, it's always like the woman that is kind of held to be like the victim, or like, you know, the person that's not being perpetrated against. But in this instance, when you're hearing what's happening, you're hearing like the live kind of court footage, it's the other way around. And like the real reality is that men suffer domestic abuse.
They do.
They do. And we know people, and there's like, especially like, can I be quite honest? Like communities, like non-white communities, if you're black or Asian, there's like, we're not comfortable to say some of the things that we go through.
Mm.
Or men, it's like you're almost meant to be
especially men. As yeah. Well.
Demasculated.
I'll commend you on that. Definitely.
What's that?
The mental health
documentary.
Like, I respect that a million. More than a million. Like, I don't think you understand.
Nice one.
I ain't got the guts to do that.
Yeah, I'll tell you that straight. Show,
you haven't got the guts?
Nah.
To do what?
I don't know. I feel like my wounds are mad deep, but I commend that. Crazy. When I saw that, especially with who was involved in it as well, I was like, rah, okay, now we have a platform.
Yeah.
Do you get me? Like, it's wild.
I know you're coming up to an ad break, but...
Yeah, you've got like 20
seconds. Before that.
Let's talk about it after 3 o'clock.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah.
That's crazy.
So guys, welcome back. It is 3:07. This is Dominican Emz and the Dominican Emz Show. Guys, I haven't even told you, this is the camera that we're looking at the moment. Everybody say hello.
Hello.
Like the queen. So I was joined previously by Skillit, Ryan Skillit.
Yeah, what's up?
My fave Trinidadian.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I was joined by Lucian.
Gucci.
Yeah.
Howdy.
And I was joined by Legend.
Jesus.
He hates it when I do that. This is Martin Shays. I love Martin. Martin is amazing. This is DJ Martin J. Martin J, my friend Martin Abraham. My mentor, my friend.
Suppose I didn't want people to know my government name.
You know what I mean? You know?
Too late. His social security is 1234. The woman.
Can you tell the people then what Martin J does and why his legacy is so important to the scene?
I was just about to. Please. So, Martin J is known as a Caribbean specialist, but he's also a DJ, a presenter, a host. You have been hosting the Caribbeanaffair in the UK for coming up to 32 years. Please don't shoot me. I want to say it was September this year. Yeah. And Martin will always say, because I've been Martin's friend. I'm gonna be honest. Martin is my friend. He's always said that this is his baby. And I see why. Because Martin, one thing about him is about the culture and what he's trying to convey. And it's something that's important to him and special to him.
Very much so.
Yeah.
Very much so.
And one thing I want to acknowledge from the get-go, Martin, and this is going to make you cringe even more.
Oh, Lord.
One thing about you, Marto, you always will talk about the people that have helped you along your journey, and we'll try and cover that all today. I'm conscious of
time. Not if you keep playing them jingles, you right?
I always press the wrong one as well, which is always really helpful. But one thing you never do, and I kind of get it as your friend, you don't really say how instrumental you are in other people's careers in different remits and realms of the Caribbean music scene, the Caribbean scene, and not just music and fundraising. Like, you've had your hand in so many pies and part of so many people's stories, my own included, and you always cringe when we talk about it.
I don't, you know, thank you, first of all. I don't think that anybody that is involved in doing stuff like this would, you know, blow their own trumpet in that way.
Have you not met the rest of the soca scene?
Please don't play any more jingles.
I'm going to do it anyway. You can't tell me what to do.
Well, it's not something that I would do.
Okay.
It's not something that I would do. But I enjoy what I do. I'm very thankful that I've been able to do it for 32 years. I still got a little bit of petrol in the tank, so I plan to keep on going.
Amazing. So, Marto, question. For anybody that is not familiar with you, how did your story start? When did you start DJing?
If I cut a long story short, when I was like 14 or 15, just after my father had died, you know, the culture at that time for teenagers was to get involved in sound systems. And as in a sound system, you had different roles. You had the box boy who was interested in building speaker boxes. You had the selector, you had the MC. And I kind of got pushed into being an MC, but I wasn't talking with a Jamaican twang. And people just used to say, boy, I want to sound like a radio DJ. That just kind of gave me the impetus to say, you know what, maybe I could do this. And then I started trying to get onto pirate radio just before Time Radio in Halsden got taken off air. Mikey Coos has invited me down as a guest DJ. So that fell through. But about a year later, I'd gone onto a pirate station for about 3 or 4 months. But a little while after that, Mikey Coos came back and he said, yo, crazy. I said, what happened? He said, we'll start a new station. Come in.
And how old were you when all this was happening?
18. Right. So I was just out of college. My name was Crazy MD at the time. I was playing Revival and Rare Groove at the time.
And you always mentioned to me your cousin Ian as well.
Ian from Satisfaction Sounds. We grew up.
I can't press the button, but I would do naturally if you weren't here.
You can press it if you want, but no, when you but when no, you no no
you gave me one instruction and it was don't press the button. But I'm listening.
When you ring me in the week and go, Mark, how did it go?
Yeah.
Then I'm gonna tell you exactly where you wasted time and done foolishness. Yeah. You understand?
This is one. I love
This is one arena where I will always be in control. Even if it's a Dominican Emz show, I will always be in control. So,
and I love you for it.
If you want to,
I'm so grateful for you.
Run it like that, then we could go like that. Otherwise, we're going to do it neatly and discreetly.
Correct.
So, Ian from Satisfaction is who I grew up with. I kind of went down the radio route. He went the sound system route. And, you know, it was Smokey who was on WLR at the time. He went away for a couple of weeks. And Mikey said, I need you to do a soca show. And at that point, I called my aunt, ran down by her in Acton, picked up some records, went on to the radio.
What's your auntie's name?
Teresa. It's Ian's mum.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
And Smokey's brother was listening to the show on a Saturday afternoon. And when Smokey came back, Terrence said to Smokey, there's a guy on the radio covering your show and he sounds much better than you.
Wow.
He just doesn't know what he's playing.
Was it because you're Dominican?
Could be that. And Smokey told me to come down to the shop. He invited me down to the shop. I went down to TJ Records in Clarence Road and I walked out of there with a box of records. And about 2 weeks later, Mikey Koo said to me, Sonny Roberts from Orbitone Records, he's going to sponsor a show. You're going to do a 1 hour show every day of the week and he's going to sponsor it. Go down to Orbitone Records. So I went down to Orbitone Records. He gave me another box of records. So within 3 weeks, I had a collection. I had a proper soca collection. And that was the birth of me as a soca DJ. I was still Crazy MD at the time. And then obviously choicefm came along. And
how old were you when choicefm came along?
It was a year later. I was 19. I started on Choice when I was 19, right. September the 30th, 1990.
Wow.
My 20th birthday was in November.
So cool.
Daddy Ernie was very instrumental in pushing me every day. And remember, this is not the days of mobile phones or WhatsApp. So this is him picking up his phone and finding me at home.
Is it Horton Cart? Horton Cart? Is that what you guys are using?
Did you say horse and carts?
Oh, wow. I think there should be like a sound noise.
No. Exactly. Don't worry. I'll go be good for she. Anyway, I'll go be good for she.
I'm in trouble.
So, you know, Daddy Ernie was very, very instrumental in that. And I got my job. I got the gig on Choice and I never looked back.
Amazing. That's awesome. That's a great story. I love that. Absolutely love that.
And Choice FM, we've got to we have to give them their flowers as well. There was all the stuff they were doing with charities and ACLT, who you are still really instrumental with today. And you've been from Daniel DeGale, all of their journey, you've been there. But were they not the first licensed black station?
It's very, you got to be very, very careful.
Go on, correct me, Mark. I
don't know. If I'm not mistaken, WNK can claim to be the first licensed black music station, if you want.
That's, that's an important piece of news there.
But WNK was doing 12 hours on, they were sharing it with London Greek Radio, and their radio station was in Wood Green. KISS wasn't a black radio station. Do you understand?
What was it, just London?
Yeah, KISS was... KISS, you know, I don't think you could call it a black music station.
Okay. Bit like now.
It was bordering kind of I don't know how to describe it, but it was certainly what, and even Choice, the directors of Choice would tell you, we're not a black music station. Stop calling us a black music station. Right. We're London Soul Power Countdown, you know, and as we evolved, then we became seen as what we were, the 24-hour black music station. But I'm not sure that we were the first, but we were most definitely the most powerful.
I don't mind being corrected, because we're educating the people as well with our culture, you know? Okay.
Definitely. Big up to 279 as well.
Big up.
Big up 279.
Big up.
So, Martin, you had the Caribbeanaffair. What was that like? Because you had the Caribbeanaffair and you've had that for 32 years, but you had one of the biggest shows as well with Jeff Schumann as well, the breakfast show as well.
Yeah, so I went on there as a soca DJ. I spent the first 2 years just being on a Sunday evening. And the Caribbean community just started to grow. You know, people were more aware of a St. Lucian flag. They were more aware of the Dominican flag. We weren't all from Jamaica anymore.
Or Trinidad.
Parents were like, I'd be in a dance and the parents would come up to me and go, you know, my children never used to listen to soca music. All of a sudden, Martin's on the radio and damning it.
Yeah.
And I love you for that. And the love that I had from the older community is why I'm here, why I'm still here. You know, the way that they would say, come round by me, and I used to go around by them. They cook food with lime. That's where I learned a lot of what I know. Now, a lot of people mistake me for being Trinidadian. Because of that,
I'm not gonna lie. I thought you were for years.
A lot of people.
For years, I thought you were Chile.
A lot of people
but
did
Brian's
that.
A massive racist.
Oh my god! I just thought he was Chile. That's all it was. I just thought you were Chile. Because I'm Chile myself. So I saw a lot of. You know, you look,
the way
you look
I talk.
Chile. Yeah, you look Chile.
The way I look.
The music you play. You know
everything.
What I mean? Yeah, exactly.
You know, people have lost money betting against that. You know.
Yeah, well, I would have lost big money, boy.
But it was just something that. I was embraced by the older community and supported by the younger community, and right. I kind of bridged that gap. Right. And that was an important definitely. Part of the growth of soca music in the 1990s. So I wouldn't say that I created it, but I just happened to be in the right place at the right time.
You're a major influence in it.
To 100%. Facilitate it. Yeah.
That's so, true. Marto, we had Cornell Phillips here the other day, and he was with his wife, his partner, Cardin XP.
Mm-hmm.
So, one thing they said about bouyon, like, he would say he's not the creator of bouyon, but he's a pioneer because they're so instrumental. And I would see you in the same way because you might not want to give yourself that title of, like, you know, creating the scene, but you're a pioneer in the scene, Martin.
For sure.
100%.
That's a fact.
You made me aware of, I'm born and raised here, right? And you made me aware.
And I thought it was a Lucian.
You made me very aware of an actual scene of our culture in this country. Like I was not connected to that whatsoever. I was more connected to my French side or more my English friends or whatever it may be. I'm not even from that area.
Is it?
I'm from Paddington originally.
Right. Garçon. That's where the real ones come from.
Yeah, that's it.
So Marto, you remember I'm very ignorant. So it doesn't matter how many No, it's true. Listen.
Yeah, fire jingles.
Jesus!
Because Marty has told me this one fact. For somebody that does accounting and has a corporate job and is very intelligent, Marty told me one fact 99 times. All I can hear is Marty's Dominican. So Marty and your mummy was born in St. Lucia.
Yeah.
And your daddy has a Grenadian connection.
No. My mother.
But your daddy's Dominican. You're Dominican.
Do you want me to explain?
Yes, please.
My mother was born in St. Lucia. Her family is Dominican. Her father is Grenadian.
Okay.
So it's just that my Grenadian grandfather, who was in the army, told my Dominican grandmother, you're coming St. Lucia with me because I'm going to be based over there, while she was 6 months pregnant with my mum. Then once she had the baby, my gran went back to Dominica.
Yeah.
And so my mum grew up in Dominica until she came here. So for all intents purposes, my family is Dominican.
Yeah.
But obviously on choice, it made sense to acknowledge the fact that my mum was born in St. Lucia and I had a Grenadian grandfather because it made me much more Caribbean. And I was my Grenadian grandfather was very, very influential in my love for soca music. And so that was an important part of my journey. Oh, you know what I mean?
Right. I want to hear that. I want to hear more about that. Sorry. Hold on. Wait, slow down. Explain how your grandfather became...
I went to Grenada to see my grandfather. And I'd met him briefly when he came over here. But in 1985, I was 14. I went over to Grenada and... the music that was pumping out of the maxis. And I was like, the youth culture in Grenada is soca music.
Mm.
When we were in England, the youth culture was reggae and soul. You know what I mean? If you was listening to soca music, it's because your aunt had pulled you by your earlobe and dragged you to a dance. You understand? So there was just a different culture. And I love that. I went to a dance at Hermitage School. It was pitch black. And my grandpa, only because my grandfather's house is right next door to the school, they let me go to this dance on my own. So there am I, a 14-year-old, at this dance, and soca music was pumping all night long. And I was like, this is me. This is me.
That's amazing.
And you can feel it.
That's where I felt the love. You know what I mean?
Okay.
I like that.
Okay. So, Martin, with your journey as well, and we had the whole story of what happened with Choice FM.
We're not going to go over that again, are we?
No, we don't have to.
Good.
We don't have to. But because when I think of that story, your story didn't end there. You've continued.
Mm-hmm.
So we have Bakhanal Radio that is like run by your brother Vinny. I always think it's you sometimes, but it's Vinny, right?
Vinny started the station.
Yeah.
Correct
me. Sorry, Vinny. Oh, please don't shoot me.
That's my guy.
Yeah, Vinny started the station, and now we run the station together.
Bakhanal Radio.
Yeah.
And it's an online radio station as well. And you've got like live shows, and you've got podcasts as well that run as well.
Yeah.
And again, you've got Caribbeanaffair, which you've continued on there, that you had started as your baby on Choice FM.
Correct.
So it continues to this day. Your live, when again? Is it Sunday?
Yep.
12 to 2?
Yep.
As well. Talk about your baby. What is it you're trying to convey? What is it you want to do with like the Caribbeanaffair?
The Caribbeanaffair is just a Caribbeanaffair. I think being on the radio brings me a lot of love, and just doing the show promoting soca music for 2 hours a week and getting the feedback that I get, it's just something that, without being complacent, it's just second nature to me now, you know? And I'm so grateful for where it's taken me all over the world, and the people that I've met, and I just enjoy doing it. So that, as long as I can continue to do it, as long as I've got the faculties to talk and press the button, I'll keep on doing it. Not them stupid jingle.
You know, you did that I miss a lot. You used to have this thing, we used to go back home and interview the artists back home.
Yeah.
The live broadcast, because the Caribbeanaffair wasn't just like in the studio like this. Martin was like in Barbados. Martin was in the Bahamas. Martin was everywhere.
You legit made me jealous. And at the same time, made me also want to get up and do more. Just by seeing that. Because I'm like, why is everyone else coming to my backyard? And
why is nobody else thinking of doing that as well?
And I can't stop watching him doing it.
We had the ability. We had the ability in those days to get a little bit of sponsorship. Tourist boards that I work very closely with, you know, all of them. I'm not even gonna like single any out. But I had the opportunity, you know, they were like, Martin, what do you wanna do? And I like, well, let me go and cover the carnival. You know what I mean? And it was, I got to the point where at the beginning of the year, I could say, all right, there you go, St. Kitts.
That's my dream.
Let me go send Vincent.
That is my dream. Might let me press
them,
the button.
Then we could do Barbados. Do you understand? Yeah. I was able to choose which three countries I was going to do for the year. And going out there, the first couple of times I went out to St. Lucia, I was so happy that I was able to portray St. Lucia in the way that we portrayed it in 1999, when they moved their carnival from February to July.
Wow.
And obviously the tourist board wanted people to know that.
That got me.
That is really, this is crazy.
I'm not gonna lie, that got me.
See history.
That got me.
This is crazy.
But we had the, you know, we, remember it was all analog them times, they weren't digital. So you couldn't just walk with a little, we had to take equipment, proper equipment, and dial up into one of them.
The AOL.
Oh my gosh. Listen, it was.
I'm back over Lucia, that ain't
easy. It was always, I wouldn't say it was touch and go, but it was stressful. Yeah, you know what I mean?
Of course.
Of course.
But it was fun doing it. It was fun doing it. And, you know, years later, you hear people say, I'm married to this woman because of you.
100%.
You know what I mean? Them kind of things.
Them memories that you're making, those moments that you're creating.
I've got to feel blessed about that. And
living legend.
Just hope that it continues for as long as possible.
So how are you feeling about, you know, Carnival coming back after a 2-year hiatus?
I'm really happy. I mean, strange enough for me, this weekend is one of the busiest weekends for me for the last 2 years, because my band is getting ready to do its photo shoot and video shoot.
Awesome.
And so, you know, it's the last minute. Have we got this? Have we got that? Have we got this? Have we got that? But I'm looking forward to Carnival this year. I'm glad that we're back. Yeah. I think it's good to see what the people feel about being back on the road. And that's important. You know, we were talking earlier on about mental health. In the last 2 years, people's mental health has been tried and tested. Mm. And so any kind of release that you can get is important. Throughout the pandemic, you know, I'll say this. As Emma said, we're friends. And if I'm going for a drive that I've got a mission to do, I'll call Emma and we'll talk for that hour and a half whilst I'm driving and cover stuff that we've got to cover, you know? Yeah. And
so grateful for you, Mark.
It's a great, it's that feeling is mutual. As much as a pain in the butt you are, I do.
Yeah,
really, really appreciate you. You know that?
No, that's lovely. No, I love this. I really love this.
Goodbye.
No, this is lovely. This is sweet. This is sweet.
You know what I mean?
So I knew the day Martin had love for you is when he came and cooked for you and left early.
Yeah.
Like, can't even men don't do that, you know. They always come to you and cook for you, and they would normally stay if they wanted to. But he obviously had things to do. But
you cannot talk about that.
That's what I was like. Yeah, he loves my sister.
It was my birthday.
It was your birthday.
Enough people were vexing me because all you came, but people didn't come. So you can't talk about that.
How do you mean?
Because I didn't invite everybody. But
oh my god!
Okay. But we were big. But the fact that we were in
up the thing, boy.
Yeah,
we were in that period where you couldn't have no big. Big thing, you know what I mean?
That's what it was. Don't forget that.
I had just, you know, I had just made up my mind when Em said, "I want to do something for my birthday," and I know she's not the greatest cook in the world.
Wow.
tell me, I'm lying.
Emma, do a jingle for that one.
Yeah. Papa, papa.
Jesus.
But I do love you. I do love you.
There's a couple guys that would disagree with you.
Hey. Let's not go there. Let's not go there. That's not the food we're talking about.
Boy.
But whilst I'm here, can I just big up I Love UK? Because this setup is incredible.
Wow, it's nice.
Incredible. And the funny thing is that I used to get my hair cut down there.
Really?
When I was coming down the stairs, I'm going, boy, I remember them stairs from years ago. Years ago, you know what I mean? And Choice FM actually had a temporary station upstairs.
Okay.
Because you showed me where they started in Brixton, where they got the plaque.
Yeah.
The plaque.
Yes. So remember, we started on 96.9, but before we got the 107.1 license, which was a North London license, we did a temporary station.
Right.
And it was a couple of doors down upstairs.
Nice.
Yeah.
If you have the powers to do this, why is it that we don't have like a UK Carnival King and Queen? Don't you think that would like kind of, I'm not saying that there is, but I'm not, like change almost the dynamics of accepting the culture in a way without it being sexualized?
When you say UK Carnival King and Queen, what do you mean? So, like costumes?
Yeah, or it's like, it's almost like you have like like a Miss World thing, but it's like as Carnival King and Queen is usually like the best.
We had that before.
Yeah, I feel we need to put,
we had a pageantry, I forgot the name of the event that happens. What's that thing that happens, Mark? It's that Carnival season before Panorama. They actually had the King and Queen.
They have the galas.
Yeah, the galas.
I'm not sure. I don't think they have the actual individual competitions anymore, but I'll be honest with you. I'm not 100% sure that competition is always great for our community.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. I would spud you on that, right?
And this is sometimes
it's normally. Yeah. I'm not doing it, but this is where I press the button normally.
Yeah, well, there's no need to interrupt me then, is there? Might as well press the button. It's shorter.
I only said that because of that. Oh.
Ladies, if you think, ladies and gentlemen, if you think I'm being harsh, I'm being harsh for a reason. Yeah? I'm just be, because she's gonna ask me, how did I do? So,
and I will.
I'm just trying
to. Emma, I'm just three times.
I'm just trying to whip her into shape. You know what I mean? I'm just trying to whip her into shape here. So, sometimes I think that, you know, we get too caught up with the competition 100. Thing.
It's true. That is very true.
But I love the fact that we as a UK community have got a lot of talent. And we just need to keep expressing it, you know? Yeah. Not always in a competition format, but we do need to keep on expressing it. And Carnival this year is going to be, it's going to be special.
Mm.
And that's all I'm going to say for now.
Therefore.
Okay. Wiki,
what's the way that they can express it through collaboration or like bigging each other up? What's the way that like people could do that to like uplift the culture?
Yeah, collaborations, you know, just doing shows. You know, going to places where you might not have been before and just taking our culture a little bit further. Both of us have been involved with the EUK Soca Monarch, right? Nine artists that took part, very, very eclectic mix of artists. Four of them have gone into a final that's going to take place in Southampton on the 5th of June in front of 10,000 people. That for me
100
is a huge win.
Yeah, it's massive for the culture.
Huge win, you know what I mean? Because there are going to be a number of people that just haven't they're going to be like, what's that?
Yeah,
you know, and we're going to go through the same thing. It's soca music. Soca, no, soca music. We are going to keep having to keep on having those conversations, you understand? But let's do it. Let's do it. We don't have to do half the things that our elders had to do.
100%.
Can I talk about something as well? And it is a bit controversial. So you have got Afrobeats, which is amazing, that's come afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
They have managed to get like their category in certain like, you know, streaming platforms.
Grammys.
And Grammys, then, and Grammys. But I can't say that you're not recognised in terms of award shows, because there are some award shows in the UK that are recognising them, but some of the major ones, and I don't even have to name names, they don't have a soca category. You have your daddy, you know his daddy's D'Alberto?
The Calypso, the Calypsonian, D'Alberto, that's my dad.
Shut up.
Yeah, that's my father. Yeah. if you look at me carefully, you probably can see it now. You're like, now I can see it.
Why
now.
Don't
like,
we have that?
Weird.
Macho. That's my dad. Baton Lara and all them things.
Why don't we have that?
Why don't we have what?
Why don't we have those categories? But what can we also do to like uplift ourselves? It's like a dual question.
Okay.
Because sometimes you don't have to wait for people to uplift you. Sometimes you pave your own way or make your own things.
I think that
all the time
is. I think paving your own way is more important than trying to get into other people's categories.
Mm.
Recently, that band, that group that won the Reggae Award.
Soja.
Oh, yeah.
And everyone went up in arms.
Yeah, because they look like Pirates of the Caribbean, but unseasoned. I like them.
But
I love them.
They won the award, you understand, because they are loved all over the world.
Look, they've got a fan. They've got a fan. Love
them. A boy like this, there's not many reggae artists you know I'll go your in music. Studio with.
Now, yeah, I'll go in studio. But what we should have is we should have our own established Caribbean music awards. Now they are little ones all over the place, yeah, but we need a big one. You understand, where we can laud and applaud our artists.
Yeah,
if we can't do it for ourselves,
100, I love you, man.
Then you know,
you're absolutely right.
100%.
And it, I believe that in everything that we do. We're going to talk about, you know, me fundraising in a minute. Similar kind of concept. Everything that I've done with the ACLT, if we don't give blood, our people cannot be helped. It's just straight science.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Simple. Thank you.
And it's just straight science, you know? We need to do things for ourselves. And the older I get, and the more experience that I gain through what I'm doing, That's what I tell the youngsters.
This is beautiful.
Because people are kind of...
I still can't get over the fact you're macho son.
and he's one of my best friends and we grew up together.
He has my condolences.
Pick up my agenda.
Look at drop your flag. Pick up your flag, girl. Emma, pick up your flag. Don't disrespect this sister, girl.
People are getting fined for that, we.
Hey, boy. Real talk. Real talk.
They won't let you back in the country, you know.
Can we just take a minute? I'm going to go back to my question, but Martin, even though some people might think you are Trinidadian for whatever reason, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
You rep Dominica. You wear your Madras.
Come on.
Martin does the best Dominican accent. I sound like Emma from Walthamstow, even without trying. You know, Martin reps his culture. Can we just
to a degree?
No, you do rep your culture. Don't even try that.
No, to a degree.
And when I don't acknowledge St. Lucia or Grenada and all that thing that you've told me in all the years that we've been friends, you humour me.
Yeah, yeah, because you need to be human. You're that kind of person.
Wow.
But
wow. Aggressive.
I am.
I love Martin.
Only
for truth
coming.
No. Yeah, that felt hard. Felt hard. You know what I mean? Put my mind. Yeah. That felt hard. If you wanted me to come here and sit down and talk on a Saturday afternoon, let me talk.
I wanted because I love you, Pale. I love you, Martin.
Yeah, I don't think I'm the most Dominican person in the world, and a lot of Dominicans will tell you that. What I don't do is I don't let somebody come and tell me how I should be.
100%.
You understand?
Yeah.
Now,
yeah.
Whilst everyone, whilst I was on Choice FM and every Dominican Independence, I went and hosted the Dominican Independence. Never charged them.
Mm.
Yeah? Now, the money's not the issue. But I know, and although I never told anybody, I know once a year, I gave you me.
Right.
I didn't do that for any other island. You understand? If St. Lucia wanted me to do something, they paid. If Grenada wanted me, you understand?
100%.
When Vincent John used to call me, he'd just give me the date. And it was always around my birthday because Dominican Independence is the 3rd. I'm the 5th, you know?
Yeah.
So we're very, very close. But, you know, I wasn't the most Dominican person. And then...
I don't like
you get it both ways, you know what I mean? It's in the same way that Trinis will say to you, Martin reps Trini to the fullest, and then some Trinis will say, but you ain't no blasted Trini.
Yeah.
Mm. You know, you understand?
Real talk. Real talk.
I am who I am.
That's a good
but
accent.
I love what you said, Martin, because when you're like, I'm gonna speak from my perspective, I cannot project onto you. When you're like us, you cannot talk about anybody's experience, Black, British, Caribbean, Black, British, Dominican. Your journey is your journey, and me and my siblings all will have a different journey from the same mother and father.
Yeah.
So it's like what's in your heart as well.
Yeah.
So what I see is, regardless of what anybody says outwardly, you rep Dominica, and you always have done, which is why I choose to ignore all the other stuff that you told me multiple times.
There you go.
I hear that. I'm going to ignore you now.
So can we talk about, like, okay, so we talked about the Caribbean Affair.
Yep.
And we talked about how you like had the opportunity to not only do that in the UK, and you've got your show that is continuing 32 years nearly this year strong. It'll be 32 years in September.
Yep.
It affords you to go around the world, to the Woman's House, to Barbados, to wherever.
Mm-hmm.
He's ignoring me. I love Martin. I like that. That was smooth.
And you've just wasted 5 very important seconds of the last 20 minutes of this show. Continue.
But one thing that has been quite instrumental in your journey and what I've known of you, like, as your friend and before, is your charitable work. So like ACLT is like a big one that sticks out.
Yeah.
There was St. Vincent last year and all the things that we did. Martin was not even sleeping. When I tell you, I actually question if Martin was St. Vince, is Vicentian, you know, for like 2 seconds.
Question if I was welcome. Vincentian. Say it with dignity and definition, girl. Hey. Oui, papa. Vincentian. Do you know what? When I saw the video of the people in St. Vincent being evacuated.
Yeah.
And they just had a little sports bag.
Yeah.
Trust.
And I was like, you're walking away from your home. Mm-hmm. You have no idea if you're ever going to see your home again, far less when.
Mm-hmm. Boy.
And all now, when I say it, my paws raise. And, you know, when that, when I called Nally, I said, Nally, what are we doing? And he said, well, let's get together. There wasn't a plan. It just snowballed into what it was. And it ended up me being involved in a way where people are starting, are you Vincentian? And I was like, no, but this needs to be done.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
We're still working. We're still sending stuff. We're still help SVG International. We're still working in St. Vincent, doing stuff.
And we can find them on social media as Help SVG as well. People still want to donate to anybody that's there.
Awesome. Yeah, we still collect barrels and that. So the work's still being done.
Amazing, Mark.
Come on.
One of the most recent things I'm doing is that I'm currently in the middle of raising some money for some cricketers, which is the Barbados Under 19 Select. People that know me know I'm a massive cricket fan. Me and my wife, we follow the West Indies all over the place, and I've got to know a lot of people. And one of the guys that I've met, sat down in the stands with, drunk with, is a guy called Norman Puckering, and he's a coach over in Barbados. And Pucky messaged me and he said, I need your help. I was like, what happened? He said, I'm taking these boys over to South Africa and I need to raise a little bit of money for them to get their traveling uniforms, you know, for them to travel with, look smart, feel part. I said, well, how much is it going to cost? And he said, about £580.
Oh, okay.
In my head, I'm like, I could send out a WhatsApp broadcast and ask a few people and... But I said, no, let me do something to show that I'm doing something. So I said, I'm going to walk 25K in the space of a week. Wow. And I was supposed to start on Tuesday. After the Easter weekend, it was manic. So I started on Wednesday. I've done 15K out of the 25. My target was 600 quid. I reached 750 yesterday.
Sorry, Mark. I'm sorry. You hate when I interrupt you, but can we just like go through it?
Mm-hmm.
That's needed. Give her that one, Mark.
Mine's gonna be like, she pressed it for too long.
So that's 30 seconds.
I love mine.
Yeah. So we reached 750, and I sat down there and I said, you know what? Let's see if we can make it to a grand. And I think we'll do it.
You more than do it.
I think we'll do it because
I do some fundraising for the Black Culture Archives. I know how that's not easy. What you just did there, you just said,
it's not an easy task.
What you just did, and to get there in such a short time. Well done to you, brother. That's amazing work.
So yeah,
that's amazing, Marto.
Thank you. Yeah,
well done.
And thank you to everyone that donated. If you're listening at the moment, it is appreciated very much. So.
And did you say a 25K walk? Did you say what did you say?
Yeah, 25K in 1 week. So. Five Ks, 3 5Ks and a 10K, you know. However I do it, I'll do it, you know.
You've already smashed 15, I wanna say.
Yeah, I've done Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. I was gonna walk here from home, which would have taken me, would have been 6K. But obviously getting ready for tomorrow, certain things started to run behind time. And I just said, you know what? One of the things that I've also learned is don't always rush to do things. Yeah. You know what I mean? Sometimes, if it's not possible, just chill out and time. Yeah, it will come back. You know what I mean?
That's amazing. But the guys, when they come, they're going to come to London as well, though, aren't they? As part of their journey to where they're going, to South Africa, is it?
They will probably stop off. Depends on the flight connection. They may be here for an hour. They may be here for 6 hours. I doubt they would overnight.
Okay. Right. Okay, fair enough. Okay, fair enough.
If they're here for 6 hours, I will go and meet them at the airport.
Fair enough.
That'd be nice.
It makes sense. It makes sense. Marto, so we touched on something. So for anybody...
You're not touching me, but go on.
I already touched you 4 times.
Not like that.
Anyway, guess that. So we have Funatik Mas. Marto, what year did you start Funatik Mas?
You started Funatik Mas?
2012. 4th of November 2012 is when we launched Funatik Mas, me and the rest of the management.
So do you class this as the 10th year?
No.
Why? Because of COVID?
No, I'll tell you why we don't class it as our 10th year, because 4th of November 2012 meant that 2013 was our first year on the road.
Okay.
So next year, we'd acknowledge our 10th year on the road, even though we weren't on the road for 2 years.
Understood. And for Funatik Mas is like, the way I know them, and you can correct me if I'm wrong.
Of course I will.
A family band. You have like masqueraders that come back year after year after year, because it's not just about the costumes. The costumes are important. We want to look beautiful. Mm-hmm. I call my section Beldyes because beautiful goddess, because it's like you want to feel like, you know, beautiful and important on the day, but it's the experience. And one thing I've always heard from like your masqueraders is like where you go over and above, where you make sure that they have a good time on the day, like the music's good, the food is good. We're here for a Caribbean experience in the UK.
Mm-hmm.
And essentially it's that. So are you excited to like everything that's happening this week that you've mentioned? Are you excited to have that? And then we've got Notting Hill happening as well.
Yeah. Was there a question in there?
Yeah.
What was the question?
Huh?
You asked, are you excited?
Are you excited?
Oh.
I did actually ask the question. Yeah. You're being sarcastic.
I don't.
He's as bad as I am, you know.
I don't know if excited is the right word.
Okay.
In your courtroom.
I think. I guess
it wouldn't be if after how long you've been doing it.
No, it is exciting. Don't listen to mine.
Actually, no. After 2 years. Do you know what?
Don't listen to mine. That I'm not giving in.
1 year, I interviewed Faye Ann Lyons. I'm not name dropping, but Faye Ann Lyons and I share the same birthday.
Right.
And a lot of people, you know, would say, boy, Faye Ann, she don't smile. She's always serious. And, you know, we were talking about that. And I said to her, people say the same thing about me. They say I'm miserable, but it's just that I want to get it right.
Mm.
Do you understand? Mm. So people that know me well know that Tuesday after Carnival, I have a barbecue and get drunk.
Right.
But it's over. I've done what I'm supposed to do. If I don't smile up until that point, it's because I'm still trying to make sure
everything's
that we get it right.
Yeah.
You know? So that's why I wouldn't use the word excited, but I'm looking forward to it. I enjoyed the rest. I'm not going to lie.
You might not use the word excited, but this year you've got big things happening. What is the Exhale? That's our theme this year. Can we talk about that, please, Marto?
Yes.
Please.
What would you like me to say about it?
Talk about what Exhale means.
Okay, so Exhale was, you know, we were thinking about a theme and thinking, you know, what could we portray this year? And Exhale actually came from two of the team that traveled to Barbados that had not been vaccinated, and so they had to stay in the hotel and quarantine. So they were there quarantining for 5 days, and I said to them, listen, whilst we're listening on in your hotel room, come up with a theme. And then they came up with Exhale, and it was just purely the fact that when we actually get on the road and you're in your costume and that music's playing and you go up to the bar and you get your drink, you'll go, and that's the exhale. And so that's what we're portraying this year. Both the adult band and Fanaticals, the children's band, we're exhaling for 2022.
And for anybody that is not familiar with Carnival and the mechanics and how it runs, the theme is an integral part of what we do in Notting Hill Carnival and on the road. So not only do you see the presentation of the costumes and the colours, there's so much thinking about like what we're trying to convey as a message, like what we're trying to do as an individual. You might look at it as a truck or a band, depending on how familiar you are with Carnival, but there's so much thought that goes behind everything that we do. So when Martin is telling you about Excel and what we're trying to do as a band, then it kind of feeds through into like the costumes as well, and what we think about the colours, what we think about the way the material looks, everything as well, isn't it, Martin?
The way that we were brought up in this, when I say we, I'm talking mainly about me and my wife, but Carnival is a portrayal. Yeah, it's a form of storytelling, and So every theme has to be, we have to try and tell that story. You understand? Your costume's supposed to look like something. Mm. Not every band does that, you know? But I think Funatik Mas would be regarded as probably one of the more traditional bands in terms of how we treat carnival. So yeah, we try and portray a story, and I'm looking forward to people seeing the presentation.
Very sick.
Can I say something live on air?
Stop asking if you could just say it.
I was going to do it anyway.
I know you were. There's another 20 seconds. Just
I want to say thank you for giving me the opportunity to have beldyesmas, because it's you that's done this.
Do you know, it's an absolute honour and pleasure to have you. I think people sometimes misunderstand you. Mm. And you got a heart of gold.
She does. Mm.
When you put your mind to something, you do it. And I admire that about you. And as much as you like confusion, you don't like confusion. You don't like confrontation too much, you know?
So
the things that you've been put through as a carnival person yourself, I think that I was kind of like, you know what, even if it's just for the first couple of years, let me guide you into this thing properly. You
so
understand?
Yeah, for you.
So
yeah, man. No,
you don't
I
take your
that.
Licks, you know?
Yeah.
You need more. If afterwards you branch out, then cool. That's all good. You know what I mean? But let me make sure that you go into this thing.
Yeah.
Fully.
He always calls me a soppy word that I'm not allowed to mention.
Yeah, we can't use that. We can't use that.
I've been here for 18 weeks. I've not said a bad word once, Mark. You'd be so proud of me.
I'm very proud of you because your mouth is filthy.
Oh, she broke it there. She broke it there. She just broke it there.
You didn't.
She just broke it there. Yeah, yeah. The first time. But yeah, big up yourself, Martin J, man.
Well, firstly, apologise to the listeners.
Yeah,
do you know what? I'm sorry to you and all your ancestors. I'm really sorry about that. I'm really sorry.
We at the Dominican.
I'm not coming on you with you again. You know?
You could... How did I manage that? There was the unintentional irony. I literally didn't mean that. I've managed 18 weeks.
Let's move on from there. Oh,
yeah. Wow.
We're coming up to 3 minutes to the top of the hour. It's gone so quickly. And I could talk to Martin another 19 years and he would tell me to not press the button for another 27. Mm. I could talk to you, Romell, Coldchizzle, for another 6 minutes.
Trust me. <That's gone. laughs> How on time's going to work? Sounds about right.
Now, but big up, so thank you both for coming on, man. No. What a great legendary story and career definitely. By Martin J. He says that he's not definitely. A legend, but he definitely, is a one of a kind. A one of a kind.
But can I just say this?
Yeah, go.
As much as I might be annoying to you, Martin, you know I love you with my whole heart. It's not going to be the first time that you're going to be here. You're going to come back again, no?
I think you mean the last time, but yeah. I will come back.
For one last time.
I'll
come back and do the show with you.
Yeah.
That'd be good.
That'd probably be your best show ever.
But I'm looking forward to see what you do your journey as well, brother. Yeah, you're great things, but you're smashing it.
But you continue. Okay, we're coming up to 2 minutes of the hour, guys. Yeah, cool. Dominican Emz Show. But listen, you continuously have music out. Some of the hits that we played today, like from last week, from this week, from a couple months ago, a couple months before, to 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Babes, come back when you've got something you want to. I'll come back.
With Pajo, Kaylee, I want to push these guys.
And we met Pajo,
you know?
Ryan met Pajo as well.
Like Pajo's energy, his focus, his ambition. I'm trying to push him some
incredible.
More.
Incredible.
Kaylee's going to be a beast.
Bring
I'm telling
run.
You now. I'm telling you.
He is
going to be a beast.
That's what I mean. I was just checking you paying attention.
Wow, you watch this space. Watch the space. See
but, but we're trying to do something. We're trying to do something collectively, so we'll do that. But guys, listen, it's coming up to the top of the hour. We literally have 40 seconds left.
Cool.
Of the Dominican Emz Show.
Big bad show.
It's
thanks for having
been
us.
Amazing. So I thank you so much, guys. With you each and every Saturday, 2 to 4 p.m. Dominican Emz, your sarcastic Dominican Cockney host. We had today Martin J, the ledge. We had Romell, Coldchizzle, And we have my co-host, my token Trinidadian, and one of my best friends, Ryan.
Thank you for having us. Thank you for having us.
Guys, let's just play the rest of this song. But yeah, we've got 10 seconds at the end of the show, guys.
You're listening to iLive Radio.
This is Tiffany Michelle from Austin, Texas.